All right, well, the forecast is looking pretty good to be outdoors this weekend. But if you've just been, you know, inside all winter, you're going to want to start slow to avoid hurting yourself. Well, we're going to be joined this morning with some advice by Dr. Zachary Vopel. He's a foot and ankle specialist with Michigan Orthopedic Surgeons. Dr. Vopel, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you. Good morning.
All right, so people are going to be getting outside if they haven't done so already. What are the most common injuries you see this time of year as people get outside and start to move again?
Well, in the spring, we certainly see an uptick in sports injuries, the side-to-side explosive-type sports like baseball, softball, lacrosse, soccer. We see a lot of sprains and strains. There are a lot of people, like you mentioned, that have been sedentary during the winter, and now they're trying to get in shape for the spring and summer, and they go too hard, too fast. And we see tendonitis and stress fractures. And then there are the people who are doing yard work, cleanup, home improvement projects, and you know, they're on ladders, they're using equipment they're not familiar with. So we see tendon lacerations, broken bones, infections. So there's certainly an uptick in injuries in the spring that we see.
Yeah, a wide range of issues. And although they aren't obviously the same, you have some that are cuts and lacerations, but others are sort of repetitive use or strains, or as you mentioned, explosive movement injuries. What are some of the ways we can prevent these types of injuries? What can we do?
Well, one big thing is appropriate footwear for the sport or activity you're doing. I certainly can advise my patients on that, but I always refer them back to our local, you know, sport-specific shops, whether it's a pair of baseball or soccer cleats or running shoes. I think stretching is really important before and after your activity. Starting slow, you know, take it slow at first and kind of ramp up your activity. And fortunately, there's a lot of, you know, online resources for that, apps on our mobile phone, like Couch to 5K. Type of a program that can help you with that to help avoid injuries. Certainly, if you're around the house, you know, be familiar with your equipment, make sure it's maintenance appropriately. Eyewear is really important as well.
Now, when people are getting out there, let's say you have an injury that you get this weekend, when do you know it's time to go into to the doctor and get some help? But, you know, gee, my knee's kind of sore, you know, I mean, because we all sort of have these nagging injuries. When is it time to actually go get some help?
Sure. Well, you know, I have a pretty low threshold when I tell patients, friends and family, you know, if they've had an injury, you know, I have a pretty low threshold to have them go and seek medical attention. You know, certainly if it's something minor, you can try the RICE technique, you know, rest ice, compression elevation. But if your symptoms aren't improving quickly, you should seek medical help. You know, unfortunately, during the pandemic, people are, you know, been kind of scared to seek medical attention, specifically at emergency rooms. And, you know, we see patients who, you know, they had a simple problem with a simple treatment, if they would have been seen right away, but, you know, they wait, you know, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks and come in, and then it's a bigger problem than it had to be.
All right, well, what are some of the options that people have? Because as you mentioned, people are kind of skittish about going back into emergency rooms given the latest surge.
Yeah, so at Michigan Orthopedic Surgeons, we're very proud. We just opened, it's called Urgent Ortho. It's the area's only orthopedic or musculoskeletal specific after hours walk-in urgent care. So we did this really last spring in response to patient and community fears of, you know, being in a crowded, busy emergency room with coronavirus patients where you have to wait, you know, maybe hours to be seen. So it's a walk-in clinic. We follow all the appropriate COVID protocols. You get seen right away, and you get seen by an orthopedic specialist. So that's really been one thing that we've got great feedback from the community as a whole to kind of keep people safe, but yet get them the expert care that they need.
All right, Dr. Zachary Vopel, thank you so much. And folks can find you at miorthosurgeons.com. That is going to certainly be something that's real important for people to get them the help they need. Thank you, doctor, so much.